What's good, guys, and welcome back to your girl's channel. Welcome back to Lonnie's World. Okay, period. So I'm here today because first I'm like half awake, but I'm back with another video. Okay, I've been slacking with the two uploads, so I feel like that schedule might be a lot. So I might have to bring it back down to one video per week, or just honestly not even just like Mondays and Fridays. Maybe I just might post like videos every week, just like, you know, because I don't know if like the schedule thing is gonna keep working out for your girl. But anyways, I'm a hard procrastinator with the big P, okay, pushing procrastination, period. Okay, so yeah, you guys are probably like, why is she in a bonnet? Like, what's going on? What's good with your girl? I'm bringing you guys a wash day routine, okay? Yes, I was thinking about this and I was like, you know what? Wash days routines are on Sunday and today's Monday. So you're like, yeah, I was doing my brother's hair yesterday and by the time I got finished doing his hair and doing his like coils, I was so tired. My hands started like cramping up. And I'm like, you know what? I'm done. That's it. So now we're doing our wash day routine today. So I'm about to take this bonnet off and show you guys what is going on under this. Girl. Yeah. So I'm going to be doing a protein treatment first or whatever. I didn't do one last week. I did one the week before last or whatever. Honestly, with the protein treatment so that your hair doesn't feel like it's an overload of protein, do what works for you. I feel like I need to incorporate protein, like, not every single week, but, like, every other week. Just so that, you know, our hair is strengthened. For some people that hair is protein sensitive, every month can work for you. But I don't want to make this, like, a long, rambling video. I'm just showing you guys, like, how I do my wash day routine, okay? And hopefully this isn't ghetto. But yes, so we start with detangling our hair and then we're going to, from there on, since this is the most manipulation I do to my hair throughout the week, because I literally just put it in a low bun on every day for the gym or for whatever else. My hair up at the top of my head like that. And then I'm just gonna take a clip just so that like all my hair stays at the top. And then I'm just gonna put this plastic cap on, this plastic bag, I guess, on my hair. Right. Then I'm gonna take my heating cap or whatever, and I can like link where I got this in the description. I got this from Amazon and I had to get this because my original hooded dryer that my dad had got me like years ago, it broke. So yeah, it smelled like when I would turn it on, it was like on fire. So I was like, yeah, this thing's done for. So I went and bought one of these on Amazon for like 20 bucks. So yeah, I'm going to go ahead, deep condition for 15 minutes, then go ahead and show you guys the rest of the process, okay? All right, so guys, I just finished the deep conditioning. I did that for about 15 minutes. So now I'm about to go wash this out and use the Karakare Hydrating Detangling Shampoo. I use this on a weekly basis and this makes my hair feel smooth and detangled. And yeah. This is pretty much like the shampoo that I use. I have other ones, but I'm gonna stick with the basics. So I'm gonna use this one. So I'm just gonna like hop in the shower really quick and just rinse that off. I'm not taking you guys in there with me to see me do that, but I'm just going to rinse this out, then shampoo about 2 times. So do one rinse, then do a second rinse to make sure my hair is thoroughly clean. And then after that, I'm gonna hop out and then just deep condition. Okay. So guys, I'm back from washing my hair. Okay, so this is how it's looking, and I just towel dried and like all the excess water I just squeezed out of my hair. Okay, so this is how it's looking. So then, and I always use like a t-shirt dryer, so I just use like an old like t-shirt that I have or whatever, and then yeah. So now what we're going to do is we have our mixing bowl, and we have our 3 penetrating oils. So we're using avocado oil. This is olive oil. Don't mind the label. I just put, instead of using like a big glass bottle, I just like put the olive oil inside of here. And then I have my coconut oil. So basically what do? Is I just take it and then just do a spoonful. If you guys can see that. Probably not. I just do a spoonful and then place that inside. And that's all you need. You just need like a little spoonful or like a small teaspoon. That's all I do. Okay. And then because the coconut oil isn't liquid, it looks like that, I just go in, take like a small little scoop, about that much, and then just place it inside. But anyways, guys, while I'm doing this, I just want to like come in here because I was like washing my hair and I was thinking, I was like, I mean, you can start to see like a little bit of new growth coming back in, but ever since I've been using like the castor oil like nightly just to do like scalp massages, like if I moisturize and seal, or after I moisturize and seal, or the days that I don't moisturize and seal, like I use it, like after like 3 days washing my hair, I've like noticed like a change in like my scalp. Like it feels like so much like better. Like I guess not healthier. I don't know if healthier is like the word, but it just like it feels like more hydrated. Like I can definitely like tell like there's like a difference or whatever. So I'm gonna keep using that and like see how I like it or whatever. But I have seen like the castor oil like challenges. I've never done them, but who knows, we'll see. So okay, after I mix the oils until everything's nice and smooth, I don't know if you can really like see that, let me see if I can show you. It looks like butter, but everything is like a nice smooth consistent basis, or everything's liquefied. So I'm gonna go in with the Teigen Honey Miracle Hair Mask. And I love this stuff. Like at the beginning of the video, I was smelling my hair and it still smelled like this stuff. Like it still smelled clean and fresh, which is like crazy because I didn't co-wash at all like last week. So yeah, this is how much. I have another one here on hand just in case. But I just go in and then I use about like three big scoops of this. Like that's all I need. Honestly, my hair, it's still like, it's not like super coarse yet. Like that's why I can tell like I still like am good with my relaxer, because like usually like when it's time to get a relaxer, like I need like a lot more to deep condition with. But yeah, it's looking so good so far. Also guys, like talking about like, maybe I should save this for like a relaxed hair care update. But I guess like I'll get more into it, I guess if I do a relaxed hair care update. I think I'll actually do that for like maybe like Friday's upload. But ever since I like switched my relaxer to the, what was it? To instead of Dark and Lovely to the ORS, like No Lie, I've noticed like a difference. Like my hair feels completely different than how it did with like the Dark and Lovely, like the box relaxer. I don't know if that's because that relaxer was the boxed No Lie or Lie or whatever. The box, No Lie. And this one that I'm using, the ORS, is Lie. I don't know what it is, but like, it made my hair feel so different, and like, it just feels like it's like straighter than like how it normally is. I don't know. I mean, in due time we'll tell. Maybe because I was with my first time using it, but it has my hair feeling like very different and very good. Take our heating cap and we're just going to put that back on top. All right, so we're gonna take our, we have our heating cap on top of our head, and then we're just going to deep condition again with the heated, with heat, for about 30 minutes to an hour this time. And then I'll come back once that's rinsed out to show you guys how my hair is looking, and then to show you guys what I do next, okay? A little bit of leave-in in, and then put a scarf and just like finger detangle it a little bit. Not like too heavy, cause it's like pretty like detangled already, like when I had pre-detangled it before I hopped in the shower in the first place and like washed my hair. But like I said, I'm just going to put some leave-in conditioner in it, just like put a scarf on top just so that like everything stays nice and flat, even though it like won't really get puffy, just because like I guess a month from when I last, from my post relaxer. But yeah, just so that it doesn't get like too frizzy, just kind of like smooth it with my hands. And then after it's kind of like 75% dry, I'm just going to then moisturize and seal it, and you guys will see me just quickly do that, okay? So I'm going in with the Auntie Jackie's Moisture Intense Leave-In Conditioner. This stuff, it's good. I like it. I want to try to find like another leave-in that I am going to like a lot too. Like, I like this one. It's like really moisturizing, but I don't know. I just don't like that the one ingredient it has in it is the wheat protein, I believe it is. Even though that's not like super harsh, it's like you can use like every day, because even the Caracare has the same ingredient in it. Oops. It has the wheat protein in it, but like, it's okay to use like weekly, on a weekly basis. Like, it's not like harming like a intense protein, I guess. But I do want to find like one that's just pure moisture based, like a pure moisture based leave-in. Just because I don't need like too much protein if I already am doing like a protein treatment. You guys get my, catch my drift. Catch what I'm saying, yada yada yada. So if you guys like have your scarf or whatever, you can like just place it on top of your head after this. I couldn't like really find like my longer scarf, so I'm just using like this like weave one just to lay down like the edges or whatever. So anyways, like I'm just going to place it on literally like just the front of my hair like that, just so that it like stays kind of flat or whatever. Like I said, this isn't really needed like if your hair is like freshly permed or whatever, in my opinion, but for some people they do use it. So I'm just going to do that and then let my hair air dry, and then like I said, I'll come back when it's like almost like fully done, and then yes, moisturize and seal. So guys, I'm back. So So yes, I am back, and I quickly took the scarf off, and I had to go pick up my brother from school, so I took the scarf off, and then I just moisturized and sealed my hair. I used, let me grab the products really quickly. So I moisturized and sealed my hair. I used the As I Am Classic So Much Moisture to moisturize. And then I sealed with the grapeseed oil. So I did wash my hair during the day. It's not nighttime, it's during the day. So I just did that like after I washed my hair. I will be moisturizing it again tonight just because I know the moisture is going to like, everything's just gonna evaporate and it's just gonna like leave. But I'll do that again before I go to bed tonight. And then what I'll do is I'll wrap my hair in like a loose bun and then put a plastic baggie on my ends just for like a couple of days when I moisturize and seal, just so that the ends and the moisturize before like I get ready to wash my hair the next time around. But yeah, guys, this is how my hair is looking. It's looking light and fluffy and it's like nice and moisturized and everything, and it's looking like a little bit longer too. Like the last time I had cut my hair, it was probably like around here, I want to say, when I had cut it, and now it's like a little, I want to say it's at bra strap length, like, yeah, like past shoulder length, around bra strap length now. I don't know if I'm gonna cut it like one more time, like into like a little mini bobby bob, like a long bob or a little bob, just like for fun, or if I'm just gonna like let it grow, I don't know. I like go through phases where I grow my hair and then I'm like, I'm a little sick of it, and then I just want to chop it into like a short little bob, but then I realize my hair is thick and then it's just like it's harder to maintain and like manage because I just really do wear it in like a low bun like all day every day. But yeah, we will see. I'm very bipolar when it comes to doing that with my hair, like cutting it and letting it grow, so honestly we'll see. But anyways, I'm going to just put this in a bun for the time being and get ready to go to the gym and work out. So I'm gonna put this in a bun for the time being and then get ready to go to the gym to work out. And yes, I think what I'll do is for this upcoming week's video, for Friday's upload, if I get around to it, I might just do like a relaxed hair update on like some things that I've noticed and that I'm liking, since I kind of mentioned it briefly in this video but didn't really go into depth about it. But yeah, guys, I'm gonna quickly just put this hair in a bun and I'm gonna close out the video, okay? Okay guys, so I'm back. My hair is in like a very loose bun or whatever. I just brushed it just to brush down like any flyaways or whatever. But that's how the bun looks with my scrunchie. But anyways guys, yep, so this is how the bun's looking with my scrunchie or whatever. So it's looking very cute and simple, low maintenance. So yeah, basically that's gonna conclude today's video or whatever. So make sure if you enjoyed today's video, you like, comment, share, and subscribe down below in the comments. And I'll catch y'all hoes in the next one. Bye y'all.